Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and Shri Amit Shah have sanctioned encounter of the Constitution at the hands of Governor of Karnataka today. Governor of Karnataka, by inviting Shri B.S. Yedurappa, who is in abject minority, by inviting Bharatiya Janata Party, which does not have majority numbers in the Karnataka Assembly, has failed utterly to discharge his duties as custodian of the Constitution and has acted as a BJP puppet serving his masters in BJP rather than serving the Constitution for which he is supposed to act and perform. BJP has launched Operation Kamal, this time from Raj Bhavan, by trashing India's Constitution and by murdering democracy. The action of Karnataka Governor, who acts as a stooge of Bharatiya Janata Party, taking his orders from BJP headquarters and the Prime Minister and BJP President, rather than the Constitution of India, are immoral, illegal, and unconstitutional. Tomorrow, an illegitimate and immoral government will take oath under Shri B.S. Yedurappa, unsanctioned by the law and in negation of India's constitution. It is a black letter day for India's constitutional norms, our democracy, and has soiled forever the high dignity of the office of governor and the faith of the people in those holding constitutional office of upholding the Constitution and the law. The letter of the governor, which is now in circulation, clearly establishes that even governor does not believe that Shri B.S. Yedurappa and the Bharatiya Janata Party have majority. He clearly does not record, and it is apparent that just because Shri B.S. Yedurappa enjoys the support of 104 BJP MLAs, it is clear that they do not have the requisite majority numbers. Unfortunately, today, we heard first leaders of BJP and BJP's National General Secretary in Karnataka giving sermons as to how Congress and JDS are not correct in forming a post-poll coalition to stake claim to form the government. We want to ask you, Shri Amit Shah, we want to ask you, Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, and we want to ask you, Shri Vajubhai Wala, if post-poll coalition having clear majority in numbers does not have the right to form a government, then why did you, having only 12 legislators in the Assembly of Goa and with Congress emerging as the single largest party with 18 legislators, form the government in Goa? Argument that is being given now by BJP that just because two parties have fought separately, they cannot come together to form a post-poll coalition, then we want to ask the Bharatiya Janata Party and Shri Amit Shah, how did you, Shri Amit Shah, who fought against the MGP Maharashtra Gomantak Party and the Goa Forward Party in the Goa election, form a post-poll coalition, and how did the governor permit you then to form the government superseding the Congress Party, which had the single largest majority? We want to ask you, Shri Amit Shah, if two parties cannot come together in a post-poll coalition and form a government, then how did you form a government in the state of Meghalaya when BJP had only two legislators Congress had 21 legislators and was the single largest party, and BJP had fought against NPEP, UDP, PDF, and HSD-PDP, the four political parties. How did you form a post-poll coalition and then form a jointly a government superseding the single largest party? If two parties can't come together in a post-poll coalition, as BJP now claims, our question to you, Shri Amit Shah, and to Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi is, then how did you form a government in Manipur, where Congress was the single largest party with 28 legislators, and BJP was a distant second with 21 legislators? How did you form a post-poll coalition, and the single largest party, Congress party, was superseded for formation of a government? The truth, my friends, is that Shri Amit Shah and Shri Narendra Modi today sanctioned encounter of the constitution, encounter of the law, an encounter of all settled precedents, permitting a post-poll coalition to form the government at the instance of Governor of Karnataka, Shri Vajubhai Wala. Governor has shamed the office of the governor. Governor has trampled upon the constitution. Governor has subjugated the law. Governor has negated all the precedents. And I don't think so. Such a person has right, moral or constitutional, even for a day to continue to hold the office. We also saw sermons by the law minister, Shri Ravi Shankar Prasad, on how the single largest party has to be called to form the government first. But there is, as they say, little knowledge is a dangerous thing. Law minister needs to understand and learn his law again. And I quote from the Constitution bench of the Supreme Court, in Rameshwar Prasad case, and in para 165, the Supreme Court was categorical, and I quote, it said, if a political party with the support of other political parties or other MLAs stakes claim to form the government and satisfy the governor about its majority to form a government, the governor cannot, I repeat, the governor cannot refuse formation of the government and override the majority claim because of his subjective assessment that majority was cobbled by illegal and unethical means. No such power has been vested with the governor. Such a power would be against the democratic principles of majority rule. The governor is not an autocratic political ombudsman. If such a power is vested in the governor and or president, the consequences can be horrendous. That, Bharatiya Janata Party and Mr. Law Minister, is the law of the country. And this was affirmed when Congress Party went to Supreme Court challenging the decision of Governor of Goa in not calling the single largest party and calling the post-poll coalition of BJP. The Supreme Court bench headed by the Chief Justice of India on March 14, 2017 categorically said, and I only quote six lines in para 3, it is not a matter of dispute that the result of the electoral process in the state of Goa was declared on 11th March 2017. The said assembly comprises of 40 elected members. The party having support of at least 21 elected members would obviously have majority. Annexure B reveals that besides the 13 elected members from the BJP Legislative Party, 3 members from the Maharashtravadi Gomantak Party and another 3 members from the Goa Forward Party have expressed their support to the BJP Legislature Party. Besides the above, 2 elected independent members have also been mentioned in the letter of the governor as having expressed their allegiance to the BJP Legislature Party. It is therefore that the BJP Legislature Party is shown to have the support of 21 MLAs.